First, we're going to start with real numbers. Real numbers are any numbers. Rational and irrational numbers are also real numbers. So you can write an equation for real numbers, such as real numbers equals to rational numbers plus irrational numbers. Real numbers include both the rational numbers and the irrational numbers. So irrational numbers are numbers that cannot be written as a fraction, as fractions. Suppose root over 3 can be written as a fraction. Suppose pi. Pi is also an irrational number. Root over 2 is also an irrational number. Moreover, root over 50 is also an irrational number, because root over 50 will make 1 into 2 equals to 5 root 2. So rational numbers are numbers that are not irrational. So rational numbers include integers and fractions. Integers are whole number. Note that 0 is also an integer. Positive integers are all positive whole number excluding 0, such as 1, 2, 3, 4, and more. And negative integers are all negative whole numbers excluding 0, such as minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and more. And 0 is also an integer, but it doesn't belong to any of the group of positive integers and negative integers. These positive integers are also called natural numbers. Most students often confuse natural numbers with real numbers, but natural numbers are the positive integers and real numbers are all the numbers. Fractions are numbers that can be written as ratios of two integers. For example, 1 by 3 is a fraction. Minus 5 by 8 is also a fraction. Most of the time, it is really time consuming to write the set of real numbers, set of real, positive real numbers, rational numbers, positive rational numbers, integers, positive integers, or negative integers. For that, we could use some symbols that would save our time. For example, for the set of real numbers, we could use the symbol this. And for the set of positive real numbers, just add a plus as the power of the symbol. And for the set of rational numbers, the same. And for the set of positive rational numbers, just as before, add a plus to the symbol. And for the set of integers that include 0, minus 1, plus 1, minus 2, plus 3, we could use this symbol. So these are the symbols we could use instead of this writing this description. So let us start with the commutative law. There are two numbers, A and B. So A plus B is equals to B plus A. We all are friendly with these laws. And A into B equals to B into A. The associative law. For example, A plus B plus C is the same as A plus B plus C. So this is the same as this is eventually a plus b plus c. Now we will explain you the distributive law. For example, a, b and c are three constants. So a into b plus c. Over here, let's take a equals to 2, b equals to 3, and c equals to 1. So, to be like this, 2 into 3. What's in the bracket at first? So, 3 plus 1 equals to 4. So, 2 into 4 equals to 8. You can also do it in the line. Into 1 is to 6 plus 2 is to 8. The reason is most students do mistake and write C, which is under 2 into 3 plus 1 is to 7. So this is completely wrong.